go to Wade for our little pause here. I'll read it exactly as written. I would ask about the reality of a Masonic conspiracy in the church causing an apostasy.
Okay.
Is there one?
I guess first we need to talk about what an apostasy is. Apostasy in Catholic vocabulary means a complete falling away from the Christian faith. So it's not just that someone has weird ideas about theology. It's not even that they have heretical ideas about theology. It's not even that they stop practicing their faith. It means they totally fall away from it so that they no longer identify as a Christian. Mm-hmm. So they'd say, I'm not a Christian anymore. Anything short of that is not an apostasy. And there is no possibility of the church as a whole apostatizing, as indicated by Jesus's very direct statements that he would be with the church until the end, and that the gates of hell would not prevail against his church. So it is not possible for his church as a whole to apostatize. Now, many individuals can fall away, and some of them have in some parts of the Christian world, but not in others. In other parts of the Christian world, the church is growing dramatically, like in Africa, for example. So you may have in Europe, for example, and to some degree in North America, although actually to a much lesser degree than Europe, people falling away from the church, but you don't have any kind of wholesale apostasy going on. And that leads us back to the Masonic. So number one, there isn't such a thing going on. You have a weakening of the church in some areas, and you have individual apostasies, and as troubling as they are, they don't amount to an apostasy of the whole church. In fact, the church is gaining in membership. It's grown in the last, say, 50 years, or even the last 10 years. So if there is a Masonic conspiracy to cause an apostasy, it's not being very effective in that regard.
Masonic, what's Freemasonry? Yeah.
Freemasonry is an organization. It goes back a couple hundred years, and it's founded on Enlightenment ideals that are frequently at odds with the church. And in some countries, Masonry, or the Masonic Lodge, as it's sometimes called, has been actively subversive of the Catholic Church. And so there have been Freemasons who've worked to oppose the church in various ways. But these days, I just don't see a lot of evidence for this. Certainly you don't have what I think the Inquirer is likely asking about, which is, you know, are there churchmen, highly placed churchmen, who are secretly Masons and secretly enemies of the church working to undo it? And I just see no evidence for that. You occasionally get reports of that, but they're never backed up with solid evidence.
Not even Archbishop Annibale Bonini?
Not even him.
Who was relegated to Tehran, I think?
Yeah, he was assigned as a diplomat to Tehran.
And he's one of the architects of the new mass, I understand.
That's right, but where's the evidence that he was a Mason? It's easy to make allegations.
Well, it's covered up by the conspiracy, of course, Jimmy.
Yeah.
And those conspirators are Illuminati.
And there's a name for that kind of reasoning and those kind of claims, and that is... actually, it's not defamation, because that would presuppose that it's truth. It's calumny. If you don't have evidence of this, you shouldn't be spreading malicious rumors damaging other people's reputations. If you want to be critical of Annibale Bonini or anybody else, fine. Be critical and offer rational arguments and evidence for your criticisms, but do not go around smearing people's names if you don't have actual evidence.
Otherwise known as the sin of detraction.
Yeah.
Thank you again, Jimmy.